Hold on to the other hands and knees.
Hi everybody, Steve Scott here, and I have two great examples of judo parents. I've been wanting to do a video on judo parents for quite some time, and I've got two of our best here at Welcome Mat, and I'll introduce them real quick. We have Rick and we have Mary Beth, and their children have been in our program for a long time. And Mary Beth, we'll start with you. You've got five kids in our program through the years.
Right.
Two of them are now black belts, which I'm quite proud to say.
Right.
Another one working on his, I
right.
know. And can you tell us a little bit why your kids got in judo?
I started my kids are kind of spread out.
Mm-hmm.
My first three are age 29, 23, and 21. And then my younger two are 11 and 13. My older three, I had gotten them started in judo because my 21 and 23-year-olds are boys,
mm-hmm.
and I was going to be going through a divorce, and I wanted something for them to have a way to just, it be their time to do something
right.
physical and
right.
stay active and be boys.
Yeah.
And that's how it started. I didn't actually sign up my daughter originally. She was 12 at the time. The boys were 4 and 6. And originally I just signed up the one boy, who was 6, and then my daughter, who was insistent that she was tough enough to do judo, wanted to do judo.
And she was.
And she was, and she's a black belt now. So the 4-year-old, bless him, he insisted. He
Before
was,
we get, this is a great, this is my favorite stories of all time. Rick, I'm going to talk about your son, Johnny.
You talk.
But Trevor was the oldest of
right.
the bunch.
Right, okay. He was 6.
And he was 6. Now, everybody, this is one of my favorite stories about coaching kids. I just love this story. So would you tell how Kyle ended up getting in judo as quickly as he did? What,
Kyle,
it's a great story. It's a great
Kyle
story.
Was 4, and he had the older brother who was 6 and the older sister who was 12. And he was very insistent that he was just as tough and just as good and just as capable as they were at everything they did. So during class, why Trevor and Hillary were in class, Kyle would do everything they were doing on the mat, on the hardwood floor, outside the mat. And it just went on, and Coach Kirk talked to him quite frequently. He kept asking if he could get on the mat, if he could get on the mat, and he said, you had to be six. So Kyle decided one night at judo that when he talked to Coach Kirk, he was 6. He was 6.
I was there, everybody. I heard this whole thing. It's absolutely true. The kid lied about his age. So he could start judo. I think it's great. I mean, and tell us. Let me finish because you're too nice about it. You know. Okay. So Kyle is a 4-year-old, right? And so Kirk and I were talking to him at the time, and I said, you know, and I said, okay, Kyle. I said, now how old are you really? You know. And he said, I'm ticks. He couldn't say his S's. I'm ticks. And so I kept pressing him, Kirk kept pressing him, and finally he fessed up. He said, okay, I'm just tore. He couldn't say 4 either. He just said 4, tore, which I thought was so cute. And he was such a good liar. You know, we said, oh, let the kid in. If this kid's willing to do this, he's got to get in judo. And he was really good. I mean,
he was very good as a kid also.
A national yeah. champion. He's now a black belt.
Yep.
And now he's in you know, going to what, University of
North Dakota.
North Dakota and studying aeronautics. And so judo's been good to him.
And he's a pilot, and he's actually starting a judo club.
Starting a judo club at
yep.
his school.
At up the
in,
college,
in North,
yep.
yeah. North Dakota.
Yep. Yep. University of North Dakota.
Well, let's ask you, why did your son get in judo? And this is Rick, and his son is Johnny.
Johnny Shepherd.
And who is now, how old is Johnny, 15 or 14?
15.
Just turned 15.
6'3", 211 pounds. And
not kidding.
Yeah.
He's in shape.
Yeah,
the kid's
yeah,
in shape.
I go to the store. I wanted him to learn self-defense. And Kenny, I have known Kenny since he was 10.
Kenny Brink, that's our head judo
Kenny
coach.
Kenny Brink and stuff. And Kenny's life was pretty much in order. Steve's life was pretty much in order. I mean, nobody's going to jail. Everybody's bills are paid and all that stuff. And I'm glad I did, because now judo has taught him to hold his anger back, because he'll get pretty mad. Mm-hmm. And this has taught him how to hold his anger back and not get in a fight every other day and stuff. And
this is important, because in judo we teach the maturity to have the discipline.
Right.
We teach the discipline. You know, there's an old saying that I learned many years ago when I started judo as a 12-year-old. There is no learning without discipline.
Yeah.
And judo is one of those things that really instills that in children. And it's, as I've said many times, you guys have heard me say, judo has been my ticket out.
Right, okay? Right, right.
And Kenny and Kirk and all the other guys who I trained and now are really coaching the kids program now are good examples of that, how judo has been a good ticket out for them as well, and it's obviously for your children too, you know. Now, tell us now, you've told us how it's helped curb his anger. Mary Beth, can you kind of talk a little bit about how it's affected them off the mat? How the judo, the discipline, the hard training, you know, how that's affected them off the mat?
It gave them what I hoped was things that it would give them, was just being able to be self-reliant and be able to depend on themselves and stand on their own. Mm-hmm. When things happen in life, you're not always going to have someone to deal with it for you. And when you step out on the mat against another opponent, and it's just you and it's just them, you only have yourself to rely on.
That's exactly right.
And it's with my children, as I said, Kyle's perfect example. He's very outgoing. He's starts things. He started a rocket club. He started at the University of Central Missouri. And he's starting this judo club at the University of North Dakota. Mm-hmm. And he stepped out on his own, and we come from a small town, but yet he went out into a very big world mm-hmm. to make his stand, and I don't think he would have had the courage to do that.
You know what you say, talking about the big world, because it is a big stage, and you know, both your kids are competing on the national, international level in the sport of judo. And you know, when you're a little kid, and you, in our program certainly, and I imagine a lot of you guys watching this who are coaches as well, you bring your kids up, you know, they graduate to a higher level. When they step on that mat, and it's like 6 or 10 mats in the gym, it's a big gym, it's a big auditorium, it can be intimidating. And that's part of the learning process that we have, and you see it in other sports too. You see it in wrestling, you see it in other activities, but certainly you do in judo, that you're out there alone with this other person, and it's a very personal thing, but it's a very big thing too. It's mm-hmm. it's a big world out there.
Right.
And that's what one of the things we do teach in judo. It's really great about that. And that's why, you know, not every kid may want to compete, but in our program, certainly if a child wants to compete, how we start them out is kind of a general judo program. And if the child is interested in competing, then we, you know, as they get good in their skills and they learn their basics, then we move them on to more advanced training where you come. Pretty much you guys are here all the time.
Yeah.
You know, that's pretty much
that's
it. These folks live here at the community center where we're doing this video. And but that's what it does. It helps them grow up.
Right.
It really, really does help them grow up. And now Johnny has, his grades are really good, you know.
Yeah, and if they go down, I said, our back's against the wall. He goes, okay, I understand.
Yeah, yeah.
He gets to stepping.
Yeah, because one of the things that we certainly emphasize in our judo program with our juniors is scholastics.
Right.
You know, we want you to have good scholastics.
Right.
And that's very much part of growing up, and that's the maturity of judo. Can you guys speak, because you guys are really good at this, can you guys speak to this about parents who tend to want to be more than parents? And this is a particular thing that I've been coaching a long time, as you guys know, and I've had to deal with parents who step beyond being a good parent, and somehow, for some stroke of luck or genius or whatever, they think they're good enough to be the coach as well. You know, and we see this a lot. You know, and I know both you guys have been in this program a really long time, and you've been really good about that, letting the coaches do their jobs, and then you can. So you have anything to say about that? I mean. Talk about the role of a parent and the coach, how that relationship can work together. Can you say something along that line?
It simply said, judo's very difficult sport. And my kids have done all kinds of sports. Judo's a very difficult sport to learn, and you need to leave it to the experts. Mm-hmm. As I've watched judo, I've watched so many hours of judo between classes and competitions. I still don't know judo. Mm-hmm. I still can't tell my kids mm-hmm. what they need to do. Mm-hmm. I can see when they're not doing something right, mm-hmm. but I can't coach them on that, and it's not my place to coach them on that. Right, that's right. Why I bring them to the coaches they have. Mm-hmm. And knowing that those coaches are going to give them what they need. What I need to give them is the reminder that your coaches are telling you what you need to learn.
Right.
Pay attention.
Yeah.
Follow what they're telling you. Mm-hmm. That's my spot in it. Mm-hmm. It's just being the parent and making sure they're doing what they're supposed to do for their coaches. Mm-hmm. It's not my place to coach them. I don't know judo. I'm not the expert.
You know, there's a chain of success. Before I let you answer this,
Jake,
there's a chain of success, and you know, a good parent is worth his or her weight in gold. I mean, you guys, it's very much appreciated from our end of it as a coach.
Right.
Because I've seen some pretty bad examples of really obnoxious parents. I'm not saying all parents are. I'm not saying you shouldn't be involved with your child's judo, as you guys are both very involved with your children's judo. But you have a role, and the coach has a role. You know, can you speak to that as well? Because I know you have worked a lot with Kenny Brink and Kirk and all the other guys.
I like Kenny. I said, I've known Kenny forever. He was 10, like I said, and look. If Johnny's on the mat, I tell him, he'll look at me. I'm like, don't look at me. You do what Kenny says. Mm-hmm. And I like to tell him stuff that Kenny tells him, like, how do you get out of a pin? Don't get in one. How do you get out of a choke? Don't get in one. And Kenny also tells him other stuff. How do you stop smoking? Don't start.
That's right.
And Kenny tells him, I said, I'm pretty good at driving a truck over the road, junking cars. I'm a very poor judo coach. I'm just a very poor judo coach. And stuff like that, but I just tell him, I said, that's why I bring you down here, because I want the best for you, because he's the reason I breathe.
Right.
So
right.
I bring him down here to Steve or Kenny and stuff like that. And if Steve's telling him something to do, Kenny don't step in, because that's his coach.
Well, you know, here at Welcome, Matt, we have, I'm the guy who started it actually in 1969. And our head coach now, certainly our junior program head coach, Kenny Brink, started with me when he was 8 years old. So, and now he's 50, and that really makes me feel old, and I am old, I guess. But you guys have been in the program a really long time, and you are two great examples of what we think judo parents ought to be.
Well, I appreciate it.
And that's why I want to have you on camera here and have the our YouTube audience and anybody else maybe watching on Facebook as well certainly watch us. And again, do we have the perfect parents? No, we all make mistakes, obviously. But I know there are a lot of you watching this that parents just like these guys who are very supportive of your program, and just the kind of people you want to have, their kids take judo from you. So anyway, just glad you guys. I just want to get you in front of the camera here and just have a few things. And and again, I think one thing real quick before we stop. Number of years ago, about 5-7 years ago, I did a very informal, a little bit of a research as to why people started judo. And I asked a variety of people why they started judo, from Olympic medalists to just everyday guys who come into recreational judo to, a number of people. And not one of them said, I started judo when I was 12 or 13 or 8 or whatever it was, to be an Olympic champion or to be a national champion. Most of them said, I started for self-defense, or my brother was in it, or I wasn't ticks, I was tore, there you go. But there's always that reason, another reason, and when they do get into the competitive aspect of it, it's their choice. You guys give, I know for a fact, you give all your kids a choice. If they wanted to, some competed more than others, obviously, and particularly in your case with your kids. But that's why they started judo. It wasn't just to be a great champion. It was to self-defense. It was to get confidence. And all the side benefits they get along, they can be a national champion if they so work hard, and the breaks are right and all that good stuff. But along the way, they're gaining maturity. They're better human beings. They make better grades in school. It's their ticket out. They'll be somebody. And I think that's the best we can do as coaches and parents is to give them that ticket out. And a chance to be a better person, to make may sound hokey to some people, but this kind of stuff does really make a better world, and I think we're involved in it. So, Mary Beth, Rick, thanks so much.
Oh, thank you, Steve.
And appreciate it much.
You're a good man.
Well,
you're
thank you.
Man.
All right. So, that's it, and thanks for watching, everybody.
Okay, be careful.
Take it down the wall.